My name is Danford Mbilinyi. As rightly put, I lead a company called Umoja Switch, a shared payment platform that provides all the technology services that any financial technology company is expected to do. But now, my role is to share what is in for the future in the space of banking and FinTech. So what is a bank? In a very old school fashioned definition of a bank, a bank is a financial institution. It's a financial institution. No one is complaining. Come on, no one is complaining. Right. So a bank is a financial institution that accepts deposits from the public and creates credit. Simple. You accept a deposit from those who want to save and issue loans to those who need liquidity. Very basic definition. A fintech is a financial technology is used to describe new technology that is seeks to improve and automate delivery of and the use of financial services. You have a bank that needs to automate the services. So there's a company here that makes use of the existing systems to transform the way the bank provides the services. And of recent, we have Alibaba, who has come with the TechFin, that this is a technology company trying to create financial services. Those are three words that will be used very frequently in this workshop from today to the last day. But now, this is very interesting. If you want to talk about the future, we must know who are we going to save? Who is this customer that we are going to save? And we have heard this before, that sometimes the attitude towards technology is just because you are born in that era. Sometimes just because you are born in that era, that's how you behave towards technology and banking. You have heard about the people who were born before 1945, the traditionists, they called traditionists, or the maturists, okay? And you have the baby boomers. You have the Generation X. These are the people who were born between 1961 and 1980. You have Generation Y, 1981 and 1995. And new one, the Generation Z, post-1995. If you were born after 1995, you are Generation Z. I think I belong to Generation X, right? Yes, I belong somewhere there. So these are the generations with different habits in terms of banking, in terms of shopping, and in terms of adoption to technology. Look at this. You have the communication, okay, signature product with generation, the maturists, was a car. That was the serious invention by then. That was a car. And you have baby boomers proud of television invention. Generation X, this is when the personal computers started, early 80s. Generation Y, you have the telephones. In fact, Generation Y is the one that is experiencing the smartphones, the tablets, and the beginning of the digital world. Generation Z is a very different one. And you're gonna see a lot of changes in the way they behave, in the way they bank, and the technology that's going to be there. We have talked about disruption in the past, that someone, I mean, there's a technology that disrupts how other people's work, but with this Generation Z, the generation itself is a disruptor. Look at the way these people behave in terms of communication. My daddy definitely used a letter. A letter. Salamu yangu zikufikia hapo ulipo. All those. The baby boomers, telephone, wired mostly. Wired telephone. That is the best means of communication by then. And then you have Generation X, text messaging or email. Comfortable sitting behind the laptop. That is me. You have Generation Y, the coming of the social media, busy with Facebooks, with Twitter. Okay. And if you are stuck with Twitter and Facebook and not enjoying the Snapchat, you should know your generation is slowly being outphased, because Generation Z is not so much into Facebooks, is so much into Snapchats and others. So the mobile apps, those are the things that attracted the new generation, Generation Z. So when talking about the millennials, you have heard about the millennials, those are the Generation Y. Centennials, those are the Generation Z, the new generation that is coming. The communication preference, yes. Online and mobile for Generation Y. Online and mobile. Wow. It's a very interesting, if you can see the last one. Preference when making financial decisions. The people of over 70, I wonder if there's anyone here. I don't think so. They would love to have face-to-face conversation with a banker. Face-to-face. The baby boomers, someone of the age 58 to 73, would definitely prefer to have face-to-face communication. But if there is online, it won't mind so much. People of my age, no worries with online. But if I get a chance to have face-to-face, I would prefer face-to-face to online. Okay? Very interesting. With Generation Y, the millennials, when they are making normal communication, they are on mobile, they are on Facebook, they are on Twitter, they are on social media. But when they come to make serious financial decisions, they prefer face-to-face. These are the people who prefer to talk to people, to talk to a banker, get advice. But not like the Generation X or the baby boomers. This is a person who has got a lot of knowledge. The word of mouth to give him comfort in terms of what he wants to invest, in terms of investment, in terms of borrowing. You don't expect this guy to come and borrow just by pushing SMSs. Forget. You need to get a method to meet this guy, whether through technology or physically. So you see, that's where the bankers get it wrong. Because we have a generation that is busy with Facebook, you think they will come to borrow because you're pushing Facebook messages. No. They prefer face-to-face. How? Physically, technology-wise, you will decide. So this is the generation that we are dealing with. These are the generations that we are dealing with. And this makes you decide the approach on how you provide the services. And what are the money habits? I'll just pick the last two money habits. The old ones, definitely cash, predominantly cash. The baby boomers, buy now, pay later. That is the era where credit cards were invented and was serious business to date. Buy now, pay later. My generation, Generation X, cautious, conservative, save. Want to save every penny. Here comes the new generation, the millennials. They aim to spend. They aim to spend. And this is where we tunagombana sana na watoto. They don't want to save. They aim to spend. Why should I save? So when the banks were busy collecting deposits to lend, these guys were telling you, no, I get my money to spend. And someone very smart, thought of this as a new trend and created services to help these guys spend. As a bank, if you are stuck with collecting deposits and issuing credits, but these guys are not saving. They're working hard to earn so that they can spend. In fact, and the banks could not provide the services that could help these guys spend. That was one. Second, they were waiting for people to come and save when these guys were not coming to save. So someone created services to help them circulate their financial transactions outside the banking sector. And that was a very smart move. So they're characterized of earning to spend and busy with social networks. The other generation is going to be different, kind of entrepreneur. So these millennials, the centennials, Generation X, Generation Y, Generation Z, have very different perceptions on how banking is conducted. To them, mobile is the bank because of its portability, because of its penetration, simplicity. Mobile to them is a bank. So any application running through a mobile is highly likely to be adopted by this generation than the other payment channels. These guys are impatient. Don't expect them to spend hours in a queue. Forget. They don't have that time. They love simplicity and quick solutions to their problems. I tried to transfer money. My account was debited. But I didn't get the money. And you take a week to resolve. After a week, this guy is in another bank. They don't have that patience. The millennials, they earn to spend. So help them spend. Or take a very rough, tough road of trying to help them save. They are not loyal. Bankers in the house, listen to this. These guys are not loyal. Mambo ya mteja wangu, forget about that. They only value what they're getting from you. If you are giving them services that are making sense, then you are together. If you give them services that are not giving sense to making sense. They don't make any sense to them. Forget. They jump to another bank tomorrow. They are not loyal. So you can even forget about the loyalty programs. Hey, give me this. Sometimes they don't even listen. You have to connect to their minds and hearts. Make them part of you. Make them part of the product. And be loyal to them before you expect them to be loyal to you. This is how they are. You say, must connect with the centennials, Generation Z, in their hearts and minds. So, forget about banking. Just start living. Start living and make them live. Help them live. As you help them live, you are banking them. Okay, I wanted to play for you a video from CBS, a very interesting one, showing how technology and the retail space has evolved. I hope it will be able to play it the other time. But the story is, you have retail stores like Amazon. We're just making use of, okay, let me put it this way. You can enter the shopping mall, get your groceries without paying a penny, leave for your home, and be debited exactly the same amount that you took, that you shopped. Alibaba has got more than 100 stores in China. You have a hotel. The interesting story is you have a hotel, you order your menu, the robotics do the stuff, the menu comes to your table, and after that, you pay using your mobile, QR codes, and all sorts of things. So the future is, you will not spend money, you will not spend cash. The future is, you may not even need a card. You may not even need a mobile. You may only need some chip embedded in your jacket or wherever. That is the future of retail. Very interesting story on the way technology is evolving. That's why you're saying, stop banking, start living. So these were takeaways from the video. You have a brick and mortar because it's a retail store, okay, and a hotel. The consumer era, what is the generation? It's the generation that is outgoing, ready to go out and spend. The channels are mobile. Everything, every payment is through mobile. And you have robotics there doing the delivery. You have e-commerce payment gateways, the Alipay. And you have a very sophisticated environment in terms of infrastructure, the connected one. So the heart of the future of fintech and banking lies on, number one, the mobile. I deal with banks. I work with a company that started primarily with ATMs. And I was so defensive because I work running a shared switch, connecting ATMs, connecting all those things. But numbers don't lie. Numbers don't lie. You have 7 billion people in the world and 5 billion mobile accounts. Why? Because the mobile is just part of me, just part of my, it's like my watch. So I have it wherever I am. And the sophistication in terms of creating new applications, thanks to the Android, that helped a lot of new developers get into the space and create new startup companies that develop Android applications. So the future lies on mobile. Look at the numbers. 7 billion people, 5 billion mobile accounts. That's the future. You will witness the rise of the digital banks, digital only. No brick and mortar. No papers, nothing. But people are banking. Biometric technology. In two spaces here, you use fingerprints, first of all, to simplify your work. You are logging and authentication process. When you start using complicated passwords, the first letter should be in caps, the other one should be alphanumeric, the other one should be, the millennials will not understand you. So with biometrics, it's simpler. That's why this must be the future. Some think cards will die. They will die slowly, very slowly. But believe me, contactless. Have that simplicity that the millennials want. Tap and go. So they will exist for a very long time, as opposed to chip and pin. That is the trend. But biometrics, again, helps in security. It's easier to fight fraud with biometrics as opposed to the other ways of authentication. Artificial intelligence. This is one of the very serious issues of the future. This is where technology is going. Artificial intelligence. Data analytics. They just tell you, this customer of yours is about to defraud you. The way he is spending, expecting 2 months' time to be hit. Utaibiwa sasa hivi. Those are the analytics and predictive behavior of AI, artificial intelligence. You will use artificial intelligence in account opening, in credit analysis, in investment decisions, predictive decisions on investment. The customer behavior, as I said, the predictive function can prevent fraud. The robotics, hi, good morning, my name is Danford, whatever. That is artificial intelligence. The future of banking and fintech lies on connectedness. Go, create your startup company. Establish your startup company. Create a very nice application and roll it out. Where? To save who? Who is banked by who? Okay? You have a retail store. You are trying to attract all the customers in town, but not all the customers belong to you. Not all the customers belong to the product that we're trying to offer. So you have to have connected systems. And this is key if you want to have total digital society. Connectedness. Open APIs, open application programming interfaces, so that you have more programmers in town, more applications, more competition. That's the future. Cloud computing. You will have people with brain, super brains, but go buy a server. Okay? How many thousands of dollars? Communication. Ooh, a lot of stuff. Why? Then if someone tells you have a hosted service here at the cloud, you pay me per transaction. Simple. Put your application here, host your application here, create traffics, you pay me per transaction. That is the future of the fintech and banking. Internet of Things, another beautiful story. IoT. And watch out, the blockchain technology. Unfortunately, when you talk of blockchain technology, people will think of digital currencies, because that is the number one flagship application under blockchain technology. But listen, blockchain is a technology that can drive a lot of things apart from digital currencies. I am not of... I come from Generation X. I may be skeptical, kind of risk averse when trying to invest in cryptocurrencies. But blockchain as a technology, watch that space. The only setback is its complexity, and that not many will go for that application in terms of development, but I'm sure it will evolve. I like that slide, the evolution of banking, pre-digital, on foot, on bicycle. You have the so-called Gari Moshi. It's a train, old styled. Okay. With my balloon and the aeroplane. That is the evolution. Pre-digital, digital one, digital two. Pre-digital, you have the mainframes. Those who have studied IT know where the computer started. We had a computer as big as this building. You have a branch, you have an ATM, and a batch processing. Collect your data, and then we analyze it at the end of the day. Or we affect your accounts at the end of the day. That is batch processing. Digital one, the social media, the mobile, the analytics coming on board, and the cloud computing. Where we are going, definitely artificial intelligence, robotics process automation, Internet of Things, IoT, blockchain, open banking. Just talked about open APIs. Okay? If you are providing banking, providing technology, you should know the generation gap. Don't come to me and try to force me adopt the Snapchats. Hey, I may not understand. But my daughter may not understand what a newspaper is. The newspaper says the way they may stop delivering letters on Saturday. Okay, what's a letter? And the other, I think that is a granddaughter saying, what's a newspaper? So that's a generation gap. The question I'm leaving to you is, what is future? What is future? You're talking about future of a 20,000 born kid in New York or in my village? Are they the same? You have heard of the center of the center, center of periphery, periphery of the periphery, periphery of the center. These are different. So when you provide your services, know your customer, know your environment. That's where you address the future properly. My name is Danford. I look like a millennial, but I'm not. I come from Umoja. Umoja is a shared payment service providing all the channels that we have already addressed. I'm not talking anything more about Umoja. This is Umoja already living the future. God bless you. Thank you for listening.